Deliverance. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Amen.
Let's go and let God have His way. That you will use us one more time. Can you use us, oh God? Expose your word, God. Expose your power, God. Expose your anointing in this house tonight, God. Oh God, set every captive free here tonight, God. Oh God, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And amen. And amen. You want to clap those hands and tell the Lord, thank you. For another Wednesday night Bible study. And I pray tonight that the gift of God will reveal itself in here tonight and come alive here and bless the people of the Lord tonight. Amen. Do I have anybody still saved? Sanctified. Favor of Jesus. But you are an absolute saint. Sanctified for my life. Anybody ask you what's the matter with me? Tell them I'm saved. Feel with the Holy Ghost. Everybody. God is good.
All the time.
And all the time. God is really good. Come on, let's go to 2 Timothy. We'll take the next 3 minutes to do what we're supposed to do. Amen. And carry on, because I believe everything is all right now. Yeah, tell somebody it's almost over. I'm on my way out of this. Amen. Let's go to 2 Timothy, the 3rd chapter. We're going to be dealing for the next couple of weeks these verses, 14 through 17 verses, as we would deal with this in parables. Amen. Everybody there?
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Starting with the 14th verse. But you must continue in things which you have learned and been assured of, knowing from whom you have learned them. And from childhood you know the Holy Scripture, which are able to make you wise for salvation through faith which is in Jesus Christ. All scriptures are given by inspiration of God and profitable in doctrine and reproof for correction for the instructions of righteousness, that the man of God may be complete, thoroughly equipped for every good work. Somebody ought to say glory.
Glory.
Now tonight, people of God, I want to deal with this text in process of studying want to talk about the purpose of holy scriptures. The only way you can gather the power of God is through reading the word of God. Take your seats. Only way you can go further is utilizing the word of God in sentence structure and obedience to living every day. Listen, most people read the scripture, but they don't put the doctrine to work for that benefit. The reason you're reading the scripture, you read them to get power from God. You read them for the anointing of God. You read them that the Holy Spirit will attend to your need. See, scriptures are there for your need. They're not just there for you to be reading a fiction storybook like we do sometimes, but scriptures are different because every time you pick up the book and you read it, something is supposed to happen on the inside, and it will give you the doctrination of the Spirit of God, knowing that everything will go your way. Amen? See, in our text tonight, believe the mother, Timothy is challenged to maintain a close relationship with the word of God. Now Paul tells him of the benefit that comes from such a relationship. It is reminded that it is a scripture which have taught him what he knows about God. In other words, You can talk to your friend, but you can't get it about God from your friends. Amen. See, when God began to allow you to read his word, he communicates with you. He communicates through you with his word. He teaches you through his word. Not only does he allow you to dive into his word, but he allows the revelation to come through your belly from reading the word of God. Anybody here tonight? When you read it, you just can't read it watching the TV. You can't read it listening to your best friend. You can't read it listening to the radio. When you read God's word, you got to have some sound doctrine around you. Because you got to look for the benefit. You got to look to God to obtain, so you can ascertain mercy. You can ascertain the power. You can get the strength. You will be amazed how God will use you to talk to yourself. If you can understand why you're reading these scriptures. These scriptures are there for your life. They're there for your lifestyle. And we come to church on Sunday morning and Wednesday night, and we listen to scriptures, we read scripture, but something ought to happen.
My God.
When you connect.
Yes.
Timothy said, the word's going to challenge you, not just challenge the word, but it challenges you to have a close relationship with the Lord. Anybody here tonight? You got to get this. You got to understand this. He reminds us that we have talked about the word of God. It is the word of God that has fed him and has led him to this point in his life. The scripture has been a foundation in making him the man of God he is. He is to continue in that he know that he might continue in the progress as a believer and as a man of God. Let me tell you something. When you can get in scripture, can't nobody tell you nothing, Queen. Can't nobody tell you anything. When you really get in the scripture and you get to know the scripture and you begin to feel what you're reading, you begin to understand what you're reading, and you know that you know that you know that you know that God will give you everything in life or any equipment that you need. While you sitting around here mumbling and bickering, you can read the word of God and let God give you some understanding, not to live this life, not to act this life, not the queen's life, not the phase life, but to your life.
Yes.
I get so sick and tired of people saying, I'm just trying to understand where she's coming from. It don't matter.
It don't matter.
You got your own problem. It really don't matter where they're coming from. If we begin to live and learn to live within ourselves, baby, your day is over.
Yes, yes.
This is what God's word is teaching us about the purpose of Holy Scriptures. Friends, tonight, I need the Scriptures and you need the Scriptures in our life as well, as we're going to be all we can be for the, listen to me here, for the glory of God.
Yes.
God Almighty.
My God.
Oh, the glory of God. Who are you doing this for? For the glory of God. Of the Lord, we need a close relationship with the Bible. Will God, we are going to grow in the Lord as we want to grow, then we need the Word of God. I hear people all the time testifying, I'm just trying to get close to God. Can you get close to God like that? You're going to have to get into the Scripture. Read the Scripture. Understand the Scripture.
Amen.
Feel the Scripture.
Amen.
We can feel one another, but we can't feel the body.
Say so. Say so.
I felt you.
Say so.
Talking about me.
Oh.
I felt you coming against me. I felt you saying that. I felt you not giving me what I needed.
Yes.
This is the wrong side of the porch.
Amen. Come on.
My feelings ain't going to help you.
That's it.
My feelings are not going to do anything in the world for you and nobody else. Anybody here tonight?
Amen.
My God.
Why did God feel the need to give his revelation to those that he used to write the Bible? Why did God feel the need to exert supernatural powers to inspire his word? These verses here that we have in this text tonight, something that we can say about the purpose of Holy Scriptures. You know, you can't do anything in life, Evangelist Ruff, until you find a purpose. We find purpose to do things, Sister Flower Shop Chopper, but we do it all the wrong way.
Oh, glory.
Amen.
We find our purpose.
That's it.
But see, let's understand it tonight. Our purpose won't get it. It has to be God's purpose. That's why we find ourselves bumping our head all the time, because we got our own purpose and God has nothing to do with it. We got our own function, but God has no option in it. We got our own power without God's power, because I'm only doing what I say I'm going to do. You don't even understand why God had you where he had you, and you're about to mess with it.
Amen. Amen.
I can't hear nobody.
Yes, indeed. Yes, indeed.
We want it. But a little bit, we don't want to earn it.
That's it.
Amen.
We want it.
Uh-huh.
But we don't want to sacrifice nothing.
My God.
We want it. But we don't want to go through nothing.
Amen.
We want it. But we don't want to understand anything. We want to just keep on doing what we want to do.
Yes.
Sometimes your wants feel good, but that from God is a bitter pill.
No.
But like drinking a bottle of castor oil, I got to do this so I can live for tomorrow. Do I want to live? Or do I want to stay in this predicament?
My God.
Sometimes your assignment is tough to the word of God. Your assignment get bitter sometimes. Your assignment becomes a battle sometimes, because God is going to try you on every side. He's going to try you on every street. He's going to try you on every area.
Yes.
Maybe it gets tough sometimes.
Amen.
I've learned a long time ago, Brother Tad, to not look at what it is, but look where I'm trying to go to.
Come on, Bishop. You're right.
Mm-hmm. See, what it is doesn't determine what I want.
That's it.
Sometimes what it is, Mother Williams, is just a stumbling block. But there's something on the other side of that block. Mm-hmm. Sometimes you have to find yourself faced with the devil.
Yes.
And looking straight in his eyes.
Look him in his eyes. Yeah.
And let him know.
Yes.
You need for no foolishness.
Hallelujah.
Because the word says, I can do all things through Christ which strengthens me.
Yes.
When I heard that, this is history.
Yes.
But your mind got to be in it. Your mind has got to be on it. I've learned, brother, I don't get excited about other folks' stuff. I really don't even want it.
That's it.
God give me strength to climb my own hill.
Hallelujah!
Give me strength to tell out my own mountain.
Yes!
Because when God gives you strength to tear down your own mountain, you protect your mountain. You protect your future. You protect what God has given you. You protect what God had you. But if it's a piece of cake, you'll give it to anybody to eat. Oh, have mercy on him. Purpose of holy scriptures, number one, they serve the purpose of revelation. Somebody say revelation. Revelation is the process of God telling you and I exactly what he wants us to say and do. Now, of course, just as God revealed his mind to the original authors, his inspiration and inspired word continues to reveal in you and I today his mind to all of those who opened the book and read it. Anytime you read. Matter of fact, you cannot read the same scripture and get the same revelation every time.
Amen.
Scriptures get deeper.
That's it.
And deeper. And deeper. That's why you got to get in there. You got to get in there and read it. It may sometimes sound like a fairy tale to you, but look who's the author.
Amen.
Look who has the power.
Amen.
Look who has the strength. Look who has the future. Look who squashing the past. Timothy, the Bible says, has already been exposed and experienced, according to Paul. Now, the Bible says they reveal God's person. The only way God can be known by us is at least now through his word. The scriptures reveal God to be holy, loving, just, eternal, glorious, exalted, loving, gracious, merciful, and a good God always. He teaches us that he is Lord, he is sovereign, he is consuming fire. He is terrific, and God is your all and your all.
Amen.
Every time you pick up the Bible to read it, you ought to be saying, God, what do you have for me next? What do you have? Do you know how many demons will leave your house if you would just read it before you go to bed? if you just read it sitting in the bathroom, if you just read it sitting on the side of your bed, if you just read it lying in your bed, if you just read it on your knee, do you know how many demons that has planned to come to you during the night will leave your house? It's having a chill in your house, and you go and you turn the heat up, and the reason you turn the heat up is that chill can go away. The scripture is the same way. That scripture is heat that you can turn up in your house, and you can read the last word, the anointing of holiness, the anointing of the Holy Spirit. Everything that bothers your home can't come and sleep with you tonight. You ain't to breathe fresh air after you read the word of God.
My God, my God.
Just expose yourself to Psalms 23. You expose yourself to the whole Bible.
Amen.
Revelation, Genesis to Revelation. Every drop of it is good. Some of it may sound like it's the Old Testament, but all of it will bless you. You got to get eagle. You got to be eagle. You got to really get it and say, I got to get my word. You got to make a commitment, not to God, but to yourself. And when you make a commitment to yourself and do it, that's when a commitment to God comes your way. And you don't have to worry about what you're used to worrying about. You don't have to worry about your phone. So every night you don't have a pattern to just turn it off and spend some time with the word of God. I'm not talking about sitting in your house speaking in tongues. I ain't talking about sitting in your house meditating on God. I said read the word of God. I just sit in the dark corner and think about God. Then you begin to ask God, why are you not doing this? God ain't no Santa Claus.
That's it.
Read to understand it. The whole Bible, Evangelist Ruff, it reveals God's power. It reveals the thoughts of God in you. It reveals God's power so much. In these scriptures, we can read the awesome power of God. And as you read the power of God, you begin to create something for yourself. You begin to create the power in impossible situations. You begin to feel like you can move in a mountain. You begin to feel like you can climb any hill and still be all right. In other words, when you really get to the power of God, you feel like you can walk on a storm. You feel like you can walk in a storm and be all right. His power to heal, his power to do anything he desires to do. You must understand tonight that you need the power of God. You've got to have the power of God. I'm just trying to give you what you got missing. I shared somebody earlier. You may want a pound cake. You may want a cold oven pound cake. But it's more than one of cold oven pound cake. You got to know what to mix with it. You got to know what to put in. That's just like the scriptures. You got to know what to read and what to read. You got to understand that every ingredient there will make something for you if you put the love back in it. I don't know about you tonight. You can walk around all night talking about, I got to read the word. It's not good until you read it. Anybody happening on your mind, that's about putting your eyes there. And let your heart receive what you need. And watch the doer's power. You got to be willing to go further. You got to be willing to take what you used to couldn't take. You got to be willing to take a stand. And let God lead and guide you and step by way. Say, I don't know about you tonight. But I got a made up mind. Whatever God wants me to have, whatever God wants me to be, that's where I'm going to be. I don't have time to keep explaining to God about my fault. When I see you know your faults, you ought to fix them. You should have to talk to God every day about your faults. You should have to tell God. You already know. That's up for you to do more and do better. Anybody else? Yeah, God's revealed is when you're reading this word and you know you're reading this word. Uh-huh. See, thousands of promises filled the pages of the word of God. Uh-huh. See, I don't know about you, but I'm living on a promise. Uh-huh. Not only am I living on a promise, but I'm living and live again. Have anybody want to live again? Uh-huh. So if you want to live again, you got to be in the promise. You got to understand the word of God. You got to know that it is so. Uh-huh. I see the saints of God need never fear that any promise of God will fail. Uh-huh. See, you're praying, but you're scared. Uh-huh. You're praying, but you ain't got no faith. Uh-huh. You're praying, but you have told yourself, I can't do this. You told yourself, I'll never make it out of this. You told yourself that you're going to be broke, busted, and disgusted the rest of your life. You've already told yourself that. So money's even scared to come no way. I can't get anybody. Blessings are scared to come no way. Because you have told yourself that you have no benefit for it. But you got to tell yourself, I can make it. You got to tell yourself that I'm prosperous. You got to tell yourself that I'm wealthy. You got to tell yourself that I'm coming out of it. You won't get in my life. You got to learn to tell yourself that. You got to tell your spirit that. You got to say, listen, help. I'm coming out of this. But I won't die. God can use me more and more for his benefit, that you can get the glory out of it. Hello. Thank you, Jesus. On my way out of this, see, every now and then, you're going to find yourself a tomb. Uh-huh. It won't be this way always, because there's a better, brighter day coming. How long is it coming, but it's going to be by and by. I'm saying by and by to all my troubles. I'm saying by and by to all my problems. I'm saying by and by to all my issues. You have a word in your heart. Down on your situation. Tell your situation. God says, I still eat the fat of the man. I still eat the fat of the man. I still not be moved. I say, grace. The presence of God. I said, praise his benefits. I said, man, that I know what I've been through with. I don't look like what I've been through with. I don't feel like what I've been through with. I don't hear what I've been through with. Because the word of God has already expelled the devil. The word of God has already refused that raccoon and told you and I, we shall make it. We shall make it. Tell somebody, it won't be this way always. There's a better day is coming by. Oh, no. Also, if you don't come out with a perfect purpose of God's scriptures, the purpose of God's word. You better understand that you got to start bragging about God's plan in your life. You got to start bragging about the investments. God says, I can have it. God says, I can do it. God says, it's already done. God says, I can make it. Thank you, Holy Spirit. You better know that you know that there's power. See, the concept of it, Brother Taz, is when you read it, it connects to what's on the inside of you.
That's it.
In other words, there's a magnet in your belly. And when you began to read and associate that word, Missionary Palmer, that magnet, and when they get together, they stir up your gifts for you. And you must understand that you don't have time to deal with pity parties, because I'm a work undone for Christ. I'm a work in progress for Christ. I'm a work under operation for Christ. And being under operation, brother, I got some instructions that you don't understand. That's why I get in trouble with one another, because you don't understand who one another is. I can't hear nobody. You try to battle me where I've already been. You try to fight me on what I already know.
Amen. Lord.
You try to tell me what I already understand.
Amen.
Your waiting and my waiting are not the same.
Not the same.
Amen.
But you can at least love me while I'm waiting.
Yeah.
And I can at least love you while you wait. Not getting your mess in your business. Because once I tell you, you can't help me. So why do you need to know?
Yes, Lord.
My God.
God is awesome God.
My God.
If the book tells you, you're going to be all right. Look to be all right.
Amen.
I don't care what the devil showed you.
Yes.
I don't care how the devil showed you. Look to it.
Yes.
To be all right.
Yes.
The devil is a lying rascal. All he wants to do is cause you to miss your prize.
That's all.
You come too far. You mess with that joy.
Yes.
Amen.
Y'all don't hear me.
Amen.
You come too far to be surprised by him.
Amen.
If it's working for you, keep working it.
Come on.
And watch and see what the Lord will do.
Yes.
Finally, the word of God to you ought to mean reinforcement. Sometimes you got to have a word to tell you to stand still. Oh, I about gave up. I about threw a towel. You ain't had no towel to throw in. The reinforcement is the word of God. Sometimes when I'm in making a decision, brother, of joy, I just open scripture, wherever it hit me at, and I see a seventh verse, I read it, which means I got my answer.
Amen.
If you connect it, there's truth to that.
That's it.
Somebody said, thank you, Holy Ghost.
Thank you, Holy Ghost.
Amen. That's sure enough truth to it.
Mm-hmm.
Much truth to it. And you must understand where you are trying to go with the Lord and benefit from it. The word of God builds up stairs that you can walk down and up and still be all right with the Lord. Don't be so quick Don't be so quick to receive criticism from one another. Don't be so quick to build up on what somebody else say. Know God for yourself. And run with it.
Yes.
Because if people, some people can cause you to question who God is in your life.
My God. Amen.
If God has given you a word and you understand it, stand on it.
Yes.
Don't look for no second opinions.
Jesus.
Sometimes second opinions will make a mess out of you.
Amen.
Anybody here tonight?
Amen.
Read the scriptures with reinforcement for yourself and build a symbol in your mind that you can understand. Read it. Sometimes you got to read it more than once if you know God gave it to you. James built a symbol. James 1:23 through the 25th verse remind us as a mirror, the word of God perfectly reflected the mind of God and the condition of man. A seed, 1 Peter plants, says, Peter 1:23, when the word is properly planted in the human's heart, it will bring forth life, growth, and fruit. The only place in your life can grow is your heart. It can't grow on your feet. It can't grow in your hand. Lord knows it can't grow in your mouth. So your heart can only receive what your eyes attain. Come on, somebody.
My God.
You can't even feel your way through this. You got to see God in it. Water is a symbol. Ephesians, the 5th chapter, 25th and 27th verse. As water, the word has the power to cleanse, quench, and refresh. Oh, it's a sword called a sword because it has the ability to pierce the heart. It is equally effective on sinners, saints, and Satan. Somebody say hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Food is a symbol. Job, the 23rd chapter, the 12th verse, the word of God is called food because it strengthens those who partake of it. Oh, hallelujah. Milk is a nourishment to young saints. Meat is a nourishment to maturity. Bread can nourish everyone. Honey, as honey is sweet to provide strength for the journey. Hammer refreshes and causes possesses the ability to tear down and build up. Nothing wrong with being a hammer.
Amen.
I come to tear down what the devil has built up around me. Sometimes we all need to be a hammer. And go in there and destroy me. He's messed up for me. Messed it up. Take that hammer and you tear down with your heart and your spirit. Fire is called because it has the power to judge, purify, and even consume. My Lord, up in here. All these things can get your heart set for heaven if you study to show yourself approvable. And the word of God will justify itself in your mind and in your heart. Thank God for the Bible, because God has blessed us beyond the ability to comprehend. He has given us, inspired us, and he has given us the ability to feel him. And he will allow you to continue to feel him if you open your heart unto him as you are reading the word of God. I'm not talking about as a soap opera or as a fiction, but as the power of holiness. Read it. God will sanctify you. That purpose must be given unto your heart. Listen, you can't even be successful in nothing until your purpose is in your heart. And once the purpose is in your heart, you'll tear down walls, you'll tear down buildings, you'll tear down anything that gets in your way and God's way. And make sure you're doing the word of God. You're doing the work of God. You understand how God has been getting the benefit out of your life. And then you will know the Bible is right. And something else is wrong, because I have the power of God before men and women. And today, you ought to go ahead and clap those hands. Thank you. Lord, thank you. Thank you. Tell him thank you.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. Part two next week. Amen. God is a good God. God is a good God.
Yes, he is.
And all the time,
God is good.
God is an awesome God.
Yes.
An almighty God. Tonight, I just wanted to share with you because we're missing it. If you don't read that Bible every day, you're missing.
Amen.
It's just like going to work and not clocking in, time clocking. End of the week, you don't know why you didn't get paid, because you never clocked in. You don't know why God has never given you any attention, because you never clocked into the Word of God. You don't have a Bible at home and a Bible at work, a Bible in your car. You don't have Word. Even if the lights, you're stuck in traffic. At least you start a Bible and read you a little scripture. You be the only one making it out of the traffic. I can't hear nobody. This is how serious it's getting. If you really want it, you're looking, but do you want it? How bad do you want it?
Hallelujah.
Listen, you can't do nothing about how they used to teach you. Now you get a better understanding. Now is your time. That wasn't your time then.
Yes.
This is your time now. The good that I've never got before. Amen.
Glory to God.
God is good.
All the time.
Father God, we bless your name tonight, and we thank you, God, for all that you allowed us to be exposed to and experience on tonight. God, we thank you for this word of holiness, God, that you continue to keep our minds stayed on thee, God. And God, I pray the Holy Spirit will continue to bless this whole house, God, the fullness of it, God, that somebody can come and say, I yield, I can't hold out no longer. This is what I need. This is exactly what I need from the Lord. And God, I pray right now that you got some bold soldiers here tonight, God, that will declare that your word is so powerful and so true, God. I pray tonight, God, that we will do it, God, until you're complete and until you're satisfied where we are. God, bless your holy name tonight. In Jesus' name we pray. Bless the whole house now. Amen. Amen and amen. Come on and clap those hands again to God's mercy. Hallelujah. Sing something for us, man. Hallelujah.
Come on, y'all, put those hands together. I'm a soldier.